It continues to pour exactly from that gas station into the street.
Here's a look at the time lapse with that severe storm developing.
It started downpouring like crazy.
We've actually seen several crashes driving. We were actually around town.
Stay weather aware because of the possibility of flash flooding.
The dangers of flash floods in the desert are real and can be deadly. This monsoon season, we're stopping by the National Weather Service office to learn what you need to know that could very well save your life.
Hurricanes and tornadoes oftentimes make national, even international news with dramatic video. While these storms can be devastating, they are not the deadliest forms of weather. Heat is the number one weather-related killer in the United States. Number two is flooding. In the summer, we experience both in Las Vegas, and it can make for a deadly combination.
Is monsoon season typically your busiest time of year?
Absolutely, yeah. Certainly from a staffing standpoint and how many bodies we need in the seats, it's the monsoon is the busiest part of the year.
Every year in Las Vegas, we experience the North American monsoon from mid-June through the end of September. The monsoon is a change in the wind pattern in the southwest part of the country. High pressure builds and sets up around the Four Corners. This funnels moisture from the Gulf of California and the Pacific Ocean into our area, which fuels thunderstorms through the season. Three things must happen for a thunderstorm to form. It needs moisture, which the monsoon brings in. It needs instability, which we get from the heat. And it needs lift.
Mountains are a great source of lift. When you got air going towards the mountain, can't go down, can't go through, it's got to go up. And so that's why on a day where the monsoon's active, you'll see the first clouds, the first storms of the day, almost always will form over the mountains. If we look up at the mountains at 9 or 10 a.m. and they're already starting to get some tall cumulus clouds, we know it's going to be a busy day.
The areas near the mountains are going to see longer, more frequent storms, while the lower parts of the valley stay drier and get more transient storms.
Thunderstorms, by their nature, are relatively small in the grand scheme of things.
Living in Las Vegas for so long, the monsoon is a normal part of every year, so imagine my surprise when I found out that monsoon season is unique to our area.
We don't call it the monsoon in other parts of the country, but we'll get what we call, you know, Gulf surges. However, it's not really the same kind of thing as a monsoon, because the monsoon relies on that high pressure, that semi-permanent high pressure that sets up over the Four Corners.
With Las Vegas seeing only 4.2 inches of rain per year on average, one bad storm could bring a season's worth of rain. When it comes to flash floods, it's not about how much rain falls, but how fast it falls.
So if we get 2 inches or even 1 inch in a couple hours, that's going to overwhelm the ground's ability to soak it in. And that's why we see so much flash flooding here.
What makes flash floods specifically so dangerous?
They scare the heck out of me, because if you don't know they're coming, you can't get out of their way.
However, at least in Las Vegas, for the most part, you know where they're going to happen due to our flood control infrastructure.
In order to avoid it, stay clear.
If you do experience a flash flood, do not drive through the floodwaters. Roads can get washed away and you may not even know it. In 2023, 400 miles of roadways were destroyed during Hurricane Hillary in Death Valley, where the area received more than a year's worth of rain in less than 24 hours. It also resulted in an 8-week park closure, the longest in its history, with other road closures in the park going far longer. Mount Charleston also saw a year's worth of rain in just 48 hours due to the hurricane. Roads were washed out, popular trails destroyed, and the only elementary school in the area faced severe damage. In 2014, storms destroyed the I-15 near Moapa, and the I-15 had to be shut down for 3 weeks to repair. For Dan, the most active year he's experienced working at the National Weather Service in Las Vegas was in 2013.
We issued over 300 flash flood warnings out of this office that summer, because it was just every day we had thunderstorms.
The Carpenter One fire made this flooding particularly bad. The charred soil was no longer able to absorb water, and the floodwaters carried debris into the valley.
There are many dangers to the public during the monsoon. Flooding is just one of them.
Of course, heat is another. And due to being on the edge of the monsoon footprint, our chance for lightning and winds are higher too. A lot of times, rain will evaporate before it hits the ground. This is a verga shower, which can pose a different kind of danger.
When that rain evaporates, it actually makes the air colder and therefore more dense, and it accelerates downward. And when it hits the ground, it goes out in all directions.
This is a microburst.
We tend to get into these situations where we can get these microbursts that produce 80 or more mile an hour winds, and those can do some serious damage over a large area.
This is the reason for the wind damage recently that resulted in so many downed power lines.
They go over time and they go over distance, more importantly. You know, if it's 80 miles an hour at first, a few miles down the road, it could still be 60, 70 mile an hour, and it just spreads.
As far as being prepared for weather events goes, the National Weather Service tries to provide as much warning as possible. All of the flash flood and excessive heat warnings for southern Nevada are issued out of this office. A heat warning, the office can issue for a large area days in advance, but they constantly have to be monitoring the radar to issue a flash flood warning.
Things like severe thunderstorm warnings and flash flood warnings, we can't really issue those warnings till we see the storm. And so that's why we have to be here monitoring, because we'll issue sometimes a flash flood watch ahead of time. So just heads up, tomorrow there are going to be a lot of storms in the area, and just, you know, keep your eyes out and avoid flooded areas and stay in if you can, that kind of thing.
This isn't our first time we've stopped by the National Weather Service. Check out our content on both heat and snow right here. And if you like this video, don't forget to drop it a like and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our content. And we'll see you next time.